Welcome to the Breakable Glass 2 tutorial. In this video, I show you how to integrate the asset into your project along with some key settings and functionalities. If you need to dive deeper into any specific topic, feel free to check the documentation. I leave a link in the description. First of all, for the asset to work correctly, it's necessary to enable the Geometry Script plugin. So go to Edit, Plugins, and search for Geometry Script. Now, you can add the glass actor to the scene without any errors or warnings. To shape the glass, you can select the points and move them. With a right click on a segment, you can add or remove points. Choose whether they should be curved, linear, or constant to match the shape you want. You can also adjust the shape by selecting the Mesh Shape Spline component inside the actor and tweaking its properties from the Details panel. You can adjust the resolution or density of the mesh to match the level of detail you need. To get a clearer view of the mesh, you can enable the wireframe mode in the actor's Details panel. There are two sampling methods to work with: by distance, where the segments are evenly spaced regardless of the curvature, and by error tolerance, which only adds extra geometry where it's necessary to maintain the shape. The glass itself can also be resampled to increase the geometry's definition, but keep in mind that very dense meshes could impact performance. It's possible to set up the glass to start already broken. Just enable the pre-break option in the glass settings and add impact points to the array. When you add a point, a 3D widget will appear, allowing you to adjust the break position. Moving the point along the x-axis lets you control the radius, and the affected shards will be removed. Now I'd like to show you how to break the glass in real time. There are several ways to do this, but let's start with the simplest one: breaking the glass with any impact, without needing to program anything. You can use any object in the scene to shatter it. As you can see, the object I'm using to break the glass is just a basic static mesh with physics enabled by default. However, if we simulate, the glass doesn't break yet. To make it shatter on impact, we just need to enable the break on any hit option. Now, anything that collides with the glass will cause it to break, even if the glass itself falls to the ground. Now, let's try to break the glass using a line trace from the character. In this case, we just create a line trace for objects within the character's blueprint. Keep in mind that the glass responds to the destructible collision channel. Let's debug to see if the trace is hitting the glass. Now, we just need to add the Event Break Glass macro and connect it to the hit result of the line trace. You can configure the default behavior of the glass when it receives an impact. This behavior can be overridden from the event if necessary. Now, let's break the glass with a stone. The asset includes a pre-configured throwable actor. but I'm going to create one from scratch to show the process. First, let's create an actor blueprint. Next, add a static mesh component to it. Assign the stone mesh and enable the simulate physics option. To spawn the stone, we can create an event in the character's blueprint. In the begin play event of the stone, we can apply an impulse to it using the camera's forward vector. However, if we throw the stone at the glass, it doesn't break. To fix this, we need to add the onComponentHit event to the stone and call the breakGlass macro from it. Additionally, the simulation has to generate hit events. Remember, the glass responds to the destructible, so make sure your object blocks that channel. Now, let's talk about the save and load system. First, we need to ensure that the save and load state options are enabled in the glass settings. To save the state, we need to call the save breakable glass state node. In this case, I'm going to use the WON key on my keyboard to trigger the save. To load the state, I make it load at the start of the game. For that, we need to call the load breakable glass state node from the begin play. And that's it! Now, every time the game starts, the glass will be exactly as we left it. As you can see, if we keep breaking the glass after loading each state, the new breaks will be added to the existing ones. The save file is stored in your project's save games folder. If you delete this file, the glass will reset its default state. Let's dive into the replication system. As you can see, replication is not enabled by default, and each client sees their own version of the glass. To enable the replication, we just need to add the breakable glass replication component into the player. It's possible to convert the glass and frames into static meshes. To do this, you can use the Bake Glass tool, which is included in the full version of the product. Right-click on the tool and select Run Editor Utility widget. To bake the glass into static meshes, we first need to add them to the tool. Clicking the Add Selected Glass Actor button will include all the currently selected glass actors. You can rename the output, choose the destination path, select which components to bake, and assign different materials. Once everything is set, pressing the Bake button will generate the static mesh in the chosen location. By clicking the Edit or Play Simulation button, you can also bake the mesh in the simulation mode. This allows you to capture the fragments in the simulated position. You can also bake the shape of the frame as a reusable component. Then, you can use this shape within any frame, adding it into the external shape profile option. Continuing with the real-time destruction, the project includes the option to break the glass using a force field, which is useful for explosions or similar effects. You can use the force field actor, which allows you to place it in the scene and adjust its radius and impulse. Alternatively, you can use the Even Force Field macro node if you want to trigger it from another actor. I'm going to add the force field to the stone to show you what I mean. For more details about the asset, be sure to check the documentation. If you have any questions or issues, feel free to contact me. Thanks for watching, and happy development!